still using ls, fine, and cat like it's the 90s. In this video, we are upgrading your terminal with modern, powerful, and visually pleasing alternatives that will make you wonder how you ever lived without them. Whether you are a Linux veteran or a newbie, get ready to supercharge your terminal with these modern alternatives to the classic Linux commands. When it comes to downloading files in terminal, wget and curl are the two of the most common tools. HTTPie does the same job but in a more human-friendly way. You have colorized, formatted output which makes it easier to understand and debug. It's a great tool for testing REST APIs. The cat command is perhaps one of the first commands you learn. It does a fine job for viewing the contents of small text files, but the bat command takes it to the next level by adding features like syntax highlighting and Git integration. Pagination option is also available to help you view large text files. You can even select themes of your choice. FYI, bat command is available as batcat in distros like Ubuntu. The du command in Linux is used for checking the size of a directory. It's not very straightforward command, and it certainly doesn't give a very good default output. Compared to that, dust is a lot better at providing the relevant information at the first glance, don't you think? And yes, it is written in Rust. The top command works as the task manager in Linux terminal. It is a good tool for looking at running processes and resource consumption. But understanding and using the top command could be complicated. HTOP, on the other hand, has a pretty colorful output and a more intuitive interface than the top command. You can scroll vertically and horizontally, configure the displayed information graphically, etc. Keys to interact with the commands are displayed at the bottom. You can also customize HTOP by pressing F2 and change the arrangement and color themes, etc. The find command is one of the most powerful and most used Linux commands. It's impossible to imagine that a sysadmin could survive without using the find command. But the find command has a complex structure. A better alternative is FT command. Written in Rust, FT is simpler to use and claims to be faster than its legacy competitor. I'll let you experiment and verify that claim. The ls command needs no introduction, but there is an alternative with better defaults and colors to distinguish file types and metadata. It's even more useful if you work a lot with Git. You can also display icons in the output if you have nulled fonts installed. The df command in Linux is used for checking disk space. While it works most of the time, an easier and better alternative is tuf, a tool written in Go. It gives you an overview of all the mounted devices, which is easier to understand. With tuf, you can sort the output, list inode information, and even save the output in JSON format. Man, I know that man pages could be too detailed and complicated at times to read and understand. If you find man pages too long to read, tealdeer simplifies that by providing practical examples of the commands. Tealdeer stands for too long, didn't read, and you can see why it is named so. I hope I'm not committing a blasphemy here, but a better Vim is not Emacs, it's Neovim. Neovim is to Vim what Vim is to VI. It adds modern terminal features such as cursor styling, focus events, bracketed paste, and overall better out-of-the-box configuration. The best thing is that you don't need to unlearn Vim to start using Neovim. What else can you ask for? And just like that, your terminal is now hotter than your GPU. If you discovered something new today, hit that like button and tell me, what's that one Linux command for which you would like to see a modern alternative? Share it in the comments. Until next time, keep Linuxing, keep customizing, and stay open source.